Okay, good morning students, and the next topic is biography in English. So the history of biography in English, what are the great books, and now we shall discuss the biography in English literature. So originally biography had a didactic and a commemorative purpose. It was meant to celebrate life and activities of important person like saints, kings, warriors, and conquerors. So in the Middle Ages, two type of biographies lives became popular: the saint's life and the royal chronicle. The most ancient example is Plutarch's life. So it's not English biography, but generally in Europe, biography is considered to be written to honor certain great personalities, especially kings, warriors, saints. Okay, so to celebrate those personalities, biographies were written, and this is not the main. In the modern context, this is not the features of biography. But just for sake of honoring great persons, biographies were written. Okay, and the greatest book is Plutarch's Lives. Plutarch is the greatest biographer, and he wrote Lives, Latin biographer. Let's say Julius Caesar, Antony, Antony, Cleopatra, Pompey. Likewise, he wrote biographies on those personalities. Actually, from Plutarch's Lives only, Shakespeare wrote Julius Caesar and Antony and Cleopatra. Okay, so Plutarch's Lives is important biography in the whole of European literature. And going to a typical English biography, the English biography proper appeared in 17th century. Isaac Watson's Lives appeared in 1640 and 1678. Then came Dr. Johnson's memorial, Lives of the Poets, and Boswell's The Greatest of All Biography. Okay, so the typical and perfect English biography was first written by Isaac Watson, and the title of the book is Lives. So Isaac Watson's Lives is the first perfect biography in English literature. And it appeared between 1640 and 1678. From 1640, he began to write, and he completed it in 1678. And but that is the first biographical book. Let's say this book is not a single person's life; it is a combination of lots of personalities' life. Okay. So then came Dr. Johnson's Monumental Lives of Poets, and then Dr. Johnson, that is Samuel Johnson, wrote Lives of Poets, some of the great poets' lives, and that is the book Lives of Poets. And this is also a biographical book because Samuel Johnson wrote on great poet's life. Okay, so this is also another greatest biographical book. And Boswell's Life of Samuel Johnson. Okay, so this is the biography on Samuel Johnson himself, and written by Boswell. Boswell is a close friend of Samuel Johnson, and he has been acquainted very close to Samuel Johnson, and that's how he wrote A Life of Samuel Johnson. And this is said to be the greatest ever biographical book in history of English literature. Okay, and Boswell was a constant companion of Johnson, and his biography of the great master tropes his life as it contains practically everything the great man did, thought, and said. So what are the feelings and everything, Samuel Johnson's every feelings and thought is perfectly expressed, both virtues and vices, everything is said in this biography, and that's why it is said to be the greatest biography in the history of English literature. And then another great biography is Goldsmith's biographical searches also appeared during this period. 19th century, In the 19th century, biographies were written, many Meyer biographies were written, and among them, the greatest biography is to be Lockhart's Scott. Okay, Lockhart wrote the life history of Walter Scott, and this is one of the greatest biographical books. And Carlyle's Sterling and Fowdy's Carlyle are also said to be greatest biographies. And what is it? In modern times, Lytton Strachey made biography writing a perfect part. His Queen Victoria and the eminent Victorians are well known. Lytton made the art of writing biography in a perfect way. Writing biographies is completely different, and how it should be written. And he is the inspiration for the biography writers. And his greatest book is Queen Victoria. Okay, and then eminent Victorians. Okay, so with that biography is completely unique and completely different, and the art of writing biography reaches perfection with Lytton. And some other important biographies of the modern times are Trevelyan's Macaulay, Church's Marlborough, and David Cecil's The Stricken Deer, a biography of a poet Cowper. Okay, so they are all greatest biographies. Today, biography has become such a popular and necessary art form that we have biographies of practically every writer and scientist or philosopher. Okay, today, biography is important genre of literature. People like to read biographies if he is a famous personality. Okay, if he is a famous personality, naturally, he himself writes biography, that is autobiography, or someone writes on the personal's life, that is biography. So biography is important genre of literature, and it is a popular genre of literature as well. A good research goes into making of modern biography. Most of them show a tendency of ruthless dissection of their subject. So now, if I want to write a good biography, I should do thorough research. Doing research is the most important feature of biography. Okay, so it is not imaginative literature, imaginative novel. So I simply imagine and then write. It's not like that. Doing research, proper research, thorough research is the most important feature in a biography. But often biography writers fail to do so. Okay, so this is a problem in biography. And another problem is that the prejudice, the personal liking and disliking made biography impure. So there are some problems in biography. In Lytton Strachey's eminent Victorians, this process of dissection became debunking of the subject. Strachey emphasizes not only understanding qualities of subject but also their weakness. Strachey says that the biographies, the individual's virtues and vices, positive and negative, both should be said. This is an important point, but most often writers fail to do so. However, today the tendency is being kept in check, and the biography is content to confine himself to an understanding of the subject and social background of the subject's activities. So now everything is in check. Okay. So if I write a biography of Sachin Tendulkar, if I commit any mistake or exaggerate anything, then I will be criticized like anything. And I have to reprint it, and then only it could be published. So in the modern context, everything is in a good way. Biography is a difficult art and calls for a capacity on the part of biographer for observing facts and stating them interestingly without prejudice. W.H. Hudson says other forms of composition deal with thought and emotion, but biography deals with source of thought and emotion. So I cannot say my own emotion, but if I write that Tendulkar's personality, I should say Tendulkar's emotions, okay, not my emotion. In such a way, I should write that is what W.H. Hudson says. And with this, English biography is also over. Thank you.